A very good morning to one and all. On behalf of IRAA, it's my pleasure to welcome all of you to this introductory class on CAT 2012. I'm very glad that all of you have volunteered to share the responsibility of conducting CAT 2012 successfully. Observers, coordinators, assistant coordinators, venue superintendents, and invigilators, all are integral part of this process, and everybody's wholehearted cooperation and involvement is required to run this show without much problem. And the people sitting here are going to represent university in respective venues. So it's important that we are thoroughly aware of the procedures for the CAT 2012. Especially so because this year we have tried to introduce some little changes to make the process easier. So that part I'll try to highlight as we proceed. So with this few words, let me start with the presentation. Now friends, this year, like last year, we have about more than 80 centers spread across the country, about 47 venues in Kerala and 34 outside. Each venue is going to have one observer, one coordinator and one assistant coordinator. Assistant coordinator is conditional. In those venues where the number is less than 400, you are not going to have an assistant coordinator. Now the test is scheduled for 5th and 6th of May. On 5th Saturday, we're going to have BTEC 101 test and MA Economics, we code name as 616 in the morning, and LLB and Hindi together in the afternoon. Now, this time we have changed the BTEC question booklet such a way that maths, physics and chemistry together, 250 questions goes in one question booklet. So that is why we have just set 101 MPC. Last year we set 101 mathematics, and then we said 101 physics and chemistry as two separate sessions with a break of 15 minutes in between. So this time it is not so. It is one single question booklet for maths, physics and chemistry together. That's for 3 hours continuous, 9:30 to 12:30. And MA Economics runs parallel in those venues where PG test is also there. So outside Kerala, only in Delhi and Calcutta, we have PG centers. Otherwise, in Kerala, in all district headquarters, we have one school where the PG runs. In Ernakulam, there are two PG centers because of too many students. So if there are 8 centers, say for example in Trichur, Trichur 1 is going to have PG and all others only BTEC. Everywhere it is so. Ernakulam 1 and 2 will be PG and others will be BTEC only. Now what you have to remember is the MA Economics is for 2 hours. So 9:30, 11:30 is for MA Economics. So MA Economics, when it is over, there will be a bell to indicate that MA is over. But that should not confuse the BTEC session. That is the only problem in making the exams together. For evening, LLB and Hindi are of the same duration, 2 hours, so they start together, end together, 2 to 4. On the 6th, PG test will be run. One change that has been incorporated this time is, PG has been shifted from bottom to top. Because there are 14 question booklets here and one here, so totally 16 questions. So if there are 16 question booklets, 16 answer sheets, types of answer sheets, and then you have to have 16 separate packets done in the afternoon. So 3 to 5, if you run PG, that is one problem, one feedback we used to get, that afternoon packing time is very slow, very low, because we have to submit the packet in the speed post by 6 o'clock, so you get very limited time. So this time we said, we thought PG will be in the beginning, 9:30, 11:30. 12 to 2 will be MCA, and 3 to 5 will be MBA. So that eases out a little pressure on packing, because you get full day for packing PG, and MBA being one single set, you can manage it. So this is how it is done. BTEC 9:30 to 12:30 continuous, no break. Please remember, there is no break. The advantage of this whole process is you don't have to collect, two times passing of the question booklets and answer books, back and forth, collection, sending the new one. I mean, that rush can be avoided as far as we are concerned. As far as student is concerned, because he has to answer more number of math questions in maths, he has the freedom to allocate time within that 3 hours accordingly as he wants. If he wants to spend more time on mathematics, he is free to do that, because the whole 3 hours is with him. So the 9:30, 12:30 business is, I believe, is good for the students and also for the invigilators, for the control room people, the observers. And MA Economics runs from 9:30 to 11:30, so that has to be kept in mind, because bell, you have to be careful. And in the afternoon, it is 2 to 4 for LLB and 2 to 4 for Hindi. So it's basically, it starts together, ends together. It is 2:01 and 3:01. Now I'll come to a little bit responsibilities of observers, coordinators. Reach the venue previous day. Ensure all packets have reached, and check venue arrangements. See, in the bag that is given to you, there is a description of number of students appearing, number of courses, the test that the venue will have, number of packets that has been dispatched. So normally, a three-digit number will be sticked onto the packet. So that number has to be checked, and then you have to report it to the IRA on the same day. I'll tell you how to do that. But make sure that the venue arrangement is good, and the packets have reached, and that packet number has to be reported to IRA. Now, what is the details like venue arrangement? Numbering has to be done. Arrow marks properly has to be given so that prospective candidate can directly go reach his classroom. Toilets must be reasonably clean and available. Drinking water facility must be provided, and sufficient stationery must be procured by the principal for whatever is required. That list has gone to him, so he has already done that. If he has not, please remind him the required stationery is important, because once the test is running, then there is no time for running and collecting new brown papers or stitching needles or whatever, those kind of simple things. He has to make sure that it is available. Now for numbering part, we have actually given a pre-cut sticker paper sheets with test code and registration, the roll number pasted on that, sticked on that. So he has to just remove and paste it on the desk. So every desk, every room must be pasted with respective roll numbers, 20 students per classroom. That you have to be, at least check some of the rooms that these things are done, at least, already done on the previous day. Now, next is arranging a briefing session. So, what is familiar to you, once you go through the instruction manual, whatever you gain from that has to be passed on to the people there. And report to IRA at the earliest. Last year, we mentioned here before 7 p.m. So, people were actually waiting for 7:65 to call and tell that everything is okay. So that's not really called for. As and when you reach there, as and when you see that everything is okay, please report to us, it is done. What you have to report is box numbers and general arrangement. The contact numbers is already available in the list. But I would recommend you do this. You do an SMS to this number, with this format. A typical example is here. Here, this one is venue code CAL1 space, then box numbers 3 with comma, then space, then comments. Okay, not okay, or something is lacking, or whatever you want to write there, put it there, and send it to this number. So that there is no confusion that I have called or not. I mean, IRA people will not say, didn't call. So there is some record. You only write down this, that will give you an idea. Center code, space, box numbers, space, comments. Okay, then we continue with the next slide. Ensure that the seals are intact. I mean, on the day of the test, when you reach there in the morning, 1 hour before, ensure that seals are intact. Ensure opening is done at stipulated time, normally 45 minutes before the start of the test. PG test, the packets to be securely kept. The reason is, PG comes on the second day. So when you happen to open the packet on the first day, if there are packets for the second day on the first packet, so you have to be doubly careful. Then end of the test, repacking is done properly. Every packet, every single box should not increase its weight. It should not be more than 25 kg. And report to IRA at the end of each day of test. This you can call and inform those numbers. The coordinator shall receive all the packets from the superintendent of the venue after the test, and he'll make sure that it is booked via post office and insured for speed post parcel, as a speed post parcel. And then the allowance for individual schools, how much money can be spent on running the show. This details is available in the printout with you. Actually, how many students are there, what amount has to be given, that has been worked out and it is given in the sheet. But remember, every bill has to be countersigned by the chief superintendent. This is the responsibility of the coordinator. He has to make sure that every bill voucher is signed, countersigned by the superintendent. Otherwise, we'll have to send it back and get it signed, so it takes time. Now, there is an order. If you don't settle things in 15 days, you'll be charged some penalty. So. It is important for all of us to see that things are settled as quickly as possible. Now this slide is for invigilators, what you must convey to the invigilators. Report 1 hour before, collect OMR question booklets, attend list from the control room, arrange a question booklet series, place one each for all including absentees, that is what we normally follow, that has to be insisted on. If someone is absent, we should not refrain from placing it in proper place. So it's important to place a question booklet in every seat, irrespective of the fact that there are students or not. Do not admit students after 20 minutes. Do not permit to leave during the last 15 minutes. Do not give extra time. Announce expiry of half time. Not log tables, calculators. Do not announce any corrections. That is one problem. Actually, we do take immense care so that there is no mistake in question booklets. But despite all our efforts, if there is one or two errors which you feel is really an error, but please refrain from making any corrections locally. Advise students to take up the issue with this superintendent, who will pass on to us, or the students can directly write to IRA. You may note down the problems and then report to us, but never announce a proper correction for all the students together. Do not announce any corrections. Collect only OMR, not question booklets. Used question booklets has to be retained by the students. Tear the top, okay. This time the question booklet is special. It has got a copy, but there is no carbon paper in the system. So we call that carbonless copy. Carbonless copy of the OMR, the bottom portion students can take. But how do they take? There is a dotted line shown where they can tear. It is actually perforated, so you can easily tear it off. But in the process, they should not tear damage the OMR. So they can take the help of the invigilator. Invigilator can do that easily. And then the top tier, the top along the dotted line, return the OMR carbonless copy. I mean, the bottom portion has to go to the students, and the hard portion, the thick portion, we have to carry. The bottom portion is very thin with blue color. The top is lightly pink. That we have to collect. Now this is the seating plan. Oh, there is a problem here. Same problem, all problem. Okay, so A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, I'm sorry. A, B, C, D, A, B, then C, D, A, B, then it is, it's correct. So this is how it has to go. We call this as U pattern. Last time we said something like this. I mean V pattern, this is U. For simple reason that there are four series question booklets this time. Primarily because there are 20 students in a classroom. So if you start from A, you will end up in D. So the four cycles will be consumed in one classroom. So every classroom can start with A. That is why this time we have four series question booklets. Now, this is how the admit card looks like this time. Last time we had two separate sheets people coming with, and one of them we'll retain and one other one students will be given back. Now this time two portions are incorporated in one A4 sheet, and this is where this has to be torn out. So we have written here as student copy, that is the upper portion, and bottom portion is the university copy. So this portion, when we tear it off here, I mean the invigilator, when they tear it off, he will retain this. And this will go to the students. So if he appears for more than one test, 101, maybe 301, maybe something else, all will be written here. So based on available time slot and qualifications, four or five tests one can appear at the maximum. So we have given space for all the possibilities. If there are three tests the student appears, then all the three test numbers will be given here. The test date will be given, test timing will be given, and this is where the invigilator will sign. Because this piece goes to the student, student will have a record that he has attended the test. Now the only problem with this is, if he has to appear three tests, he has to have three copies of the admit card. That we have instructed the students in the instruction to students. So he'll definitely have more number of admit cards. If he doesn't have, we can keep a Xerox copy and then use it. So basically the point is, the two-piece admit card serves multiple purpose. This portion, as it goes to the student, he'll keep it as a record for the fact that he has attended the test. The bottom portion here, there is a declaration where the student will sign and the parent will sign. The parent signature and candidate signature. So the declarant here says, I'll abide by the rules of the university and I have no objection in taking my fingerprint. That is the two things done there. So this, when we collect, it becomes a document for the university. That is why it is important to cut here and get the bottom portion transmitted to the IRA. This information we have given to the invigilators. So they will faithfully do that. Now, there are possibilities. The photo and signature this time are uploaded mostly by the students. So it is quite natural that some of the photos are not good quality. They're not really, face is not recognizable. Sometimes signature is not clear. Sometimes it is very faded. Then in such cases, we have objected. The status is signature error or photo error. That is how this person is maintained in the database. We have actually gone through all the 40,000 signatures and 40,000 photos and identified some of certain photos and signatures which are not good quality. So we have objected to that. That means photo objected or signature objected. In such cases, suppose this fellow's photo is objected, then this space will be blank when he takes the admit card. What he says here will be photo error. Photo error will come and say paste a fresh photo here. So what he has to do is when he downloads the PDF, the admit card, you'll see that it is photo error. Then he is being instructed to do this. What he'll do is he'll paste a photo there on the top and the bottom portions, and then sign across it. And he'll report to the observer or superintendent on the day of the exam and sign here in this space in the presence of observer. So he'll make sure that the signature he has put on the photo and signature here are same. If there is a photo here, signature here, that means it is not objected. There may be a small mark here, but doesn't matter. If the signature is objected to, what will be written here is signature space. If the photo is objected, you will say photo error here. In this section, it will be photo error. If signature is objected, it will be written here, signature objected, and signature space will be written there. That means that is where the student will sign in the presence of observer. But how do we know that the person who are going there know that this fellow is a person whose photo has been objected? That information is available in the attendance list. Attendance list is a paper where we have the photo and signature model, the bundle. 20 bundles you will get. Each of that bundle will go to the classroom. So in that bundle, there is one line where the photo status is given. Yes means photo, no problem. No means, that means that photo is objected. Even if photo is objected and it doesn't come in the admit card, it will definitely be there in the attendance list. So that you will know that the photo is not very clear and it is objected. So the gentleman comes with a problem that I have pasted my photo and it has to be approved, then you can look at the list and say that it is actually objected and you can do that. There are cases where it is not objected, but he'll try to manipulate by pasting someone else's photo and then someone else will come for the test. And I mean, that kind of remote chances we have to anticipate. That is why the objected photo is given in the attendance list, and the fact that it is objected is also mentioned in the attendance list. So this is how the new OMR looks like. No, too many details that we used to ask for in the last year has been removed. Venue details, center code, and blah blah, all those stuff is removed, and only thing is he has to write the roll number. And every roll number is 5-digit. It starts from 5 ones, 1111. So all the roll number he'll write here, and please remember, take it very seriously, this is the place where he writes the question booklet series code, ABCD, that he has to invariably mark. Despite our repeat warning and reminding, people still forget to write the question booklet code. This time, to make doubly sure that he writes it, we have incorporated one column additionally in the attendance list where the student puts the signature. There is one more column where he actually writes the question booklet code. Here the question booklet code is marked ABCD, blackened, but in the attendance list, before putting a signature, he has to mark the question booklet code. So if he forgets here, we can take out his attendance list and see that actually which question booklet he has got. And because this time we have only one OMR, initially when the announcement is done, normally he writes it. Last time our experience is maths, many people have written the question booklet. Physics, chemistry, second OMR, many people forgot. So this time, because it's only one OMR, there are less chances, but still it's important to remind again and again to see that this thing is not happening. Very tragic end is, last time I think we have removed about 1,000 students just for want of correct question booklet code. See, at the time, the evaluation happens in short time, like 5 to 10 days, and then that time, there is no way we can call up students or trace back what we have missed. So if the question booklet series code is not there, we do not have a proper key to value his answer book, and there is no way we can value that. There is no way we can rank him. So he has to be naturally out of the list. So that is really very sad to do that, but That is why this time we have cut down all other details and just roll number and the question booklet series. If he forgets here, when the signature comes, he has to write that booklet code again. So I think that will serve the purpose. But remember, this time it is only pen, no pencil at all. Whatever he writes, whatever he marks, everything is pen, ball pen. Blue or black, it hardly matters. One of the fallout of this change is that he cannot correct. There is no way he can make a correction. So he has to be careful in marking the choice. Once it is marked, then there's no way he can change. On this side, it is shown how to mark it. The instruction is given on this side. This is half only top portion of the OMR. This is the bottom portion of the OMR where the venue seal and signature are to be given after collecting it. Now let me quickly go through the forms. Form 1 is invigilator's report. So when you distribute that everything in the classroom, in control room, every room will be provided with the invigilator's report. So that form is form number 1. So that is not a part of the booklet now. It is separate. That form I have not shown, but remember that form additionally has bottom portion, this time introduced. It can so happen that the photo that is given and the person that is sitting for exam writing do have different facial characters, partly because they have cut their remove their hair. Maybe the photo he has given is slightly odd. But anyway, if the invigilator feels there is some mismatch, that instant he can record in the invigilator report. So suspicious roll numbers, suspicious identity roll numbers, one can note down in the form number 1. So normally in form number 1, what we write is present people numbers and absentees number. Continuous roll number we'll write, and then at the bottom we have introduced an additional area where this type of suspicious roll numbers can be noted down so that we can take remedial measures later on. Form number 2 is the certificate of opening, usual one. You have to say that what time you have opened it, and all the 4 people have to sign there. It's not very important. Now form 3 is usage of QB and OMR. This is a part of question booklet. It is given as 2 separate sheets. Used to be together in one sheet, but now this time because it's a booklet, we have changed it into 2 separate sheets. This is an old booklet, old one, so forget it. Now this is from that you have to compile absentees list. That is also given in the booklet. Now comes return packing. The booklet is, this is also given in the form. Please follow that. Now, regarding the centers where there are LLB, apart from Delhi and Calcutta, where there are full PG courses, tests being done, there are other centers like Bangalore, Jamshedpur, and 1 or 2 more, where you have LLB in the evening. Saturday evening, LLB test will be done. Not many people are there, will be there, but still because students have requested for, we have kept LLB test as well in the afternoon. So when we open the cardboard box in the morning, the LLB question booklets and OMR will be available in the morning because you have opened the box. But it's important to keep that LLB question paper safe till 2 o'clock in the evening when you require that. Now please remember, this every year we used to have less than 1,000 LLB applicants, but this time we've got 3,400 LLB applicants. Mostly, it's my personal feeling, many of them have reached that point by mistake. They have applied for BTEC, MSc Photonics and LLB. That option they have clicked unknowingly, and then they're all in 101, 201 category. That means they have to appear in the admit card. It will be written 101, 201. So because we have given an admit card with 201, we have to make sure that there is question booklets and answer books available in the afternoon and people available in the afternoon. Not many people will turn out. So don't be, it's not very unusual that even nobody comes for the evening test. It's also possible. Unused OMR and QB to be returned to IRA. Used question booklet, the question booklet that the students have used, it goes to student. But unused question booklets and OMR have to come back. Now, last time there was a confusion, should we pack that in two separate boxes? And it's not important. If it can be packed in one, please do the pack it in one and then send it, because it can at least save a little bit postal charges. Because when we say you pack these packets in one and others in two, sometimes there is a confusion, people do ulta. And then we had a little tough time in tracing the missed papers. So if possible, if it is possible to accommodate them in one box which is less than 25 kg, you're free to do that. Calcutta Center, venue 1 and 2 are, who's going to Calcutta? Okay, please note, venue 1 and 2 is basically one and the same school. We have, for a practical application, we said it is 1 and 2. So in that aspect, we have not kept two separate boxes of LLB for two different venues. Because Uttaman is there, he'll take care. Huh? You have to slightly adjust it. And PG centers, 101 and 316 runs parallel in the morning. That's what I think I told you before. Bell timings to be noted. 2-hour bell for 616 to be ignored. I mean, that's what I tried to impress upon you in the beginning. 101 is for 3 hours and 616 is for 2 hours. So when they run parallelly, there will be an end bell for 616, which is not an end bell for 101. I'm sorry, okay, this is like packing, how it goes, like 1 and 1, 2, 3, and I mean, these details are there in the packing list. Please follow that. Now, some of the scenarios which you probably will face in the course of conducting the test. Photo and person differ. I mean, this problem might arise quite often. Make a note of it in the invigilator's report and let him write. We don't make a scene at that moment. We don't call the fellow and take it into the superintendent and make a question and then try to identify. I mean, don't make a scene. Just note it down in the invigilator's report. See, of the 30,000 people, 40,000 people who write exam, we get 1,000 students. So if an ingenuine person actually comes walk in for an interview, then actually gets admission, we'll think about it. So we'll have a data of such suspicious cases, and then we'll act upon that as a case comes. Then no admit card and name in the, no admit card, students comes with no admit card, but his name is there in the rolls. He tells I am so and so, he comes with a proof, ID, and say that I am so, and that is apparent that he is Mr. So-and-so. Then if he checks that, and if his name is there in the rolls, then maybe convinced he can be permitted to write, and then note it down in the attendance list. Valid ID proof required. I mean, he has to show that he is the right person. If possible, get a photostat copy of the same. And it's possible that no admit card, no name in the rolls, still he claims I am a applicant, and he makes a scene. Then normally we don't permit them, because whoever is remotely possible to write, we have the database and we have tried to accommodate him. The fact that his name is not there in the attendance list or in the rolls, then normally he is not eligible. But if he still insists, and then if you feel like this is a genuine case, please contact IRA and then pass on the information, then we'll try to get back to you. Because in such cases, the students will come early. Please. He'll go as the last person. He'll not come in between. Because he will not have a roll number. So that we have to adjust here and then communicate with you if possible there is time. See, if he comes right at 9:25 and say I have to get in, you just tell him no. If he comes sufficiently early and if we can accommodate him, because our attitude is basically to, if possible, give the advantage of suspicion to the students and then accommodate as many students as possible. If he has actually paid the application fee, and if he comes with the proof that he has paid some application fee and kind of things, if it's possible, we'll accommodate him. We'll reject him at the, if it is not possible to accommodate at any cost, then we'll reject him. But you see, if he comes in the last, say, after 9 o'clock, if such people come, then you'll not be able to entertain such requests. You'll be busy otherwise. Don't do that. If he comes sufficiently early or comes one day before or something like that, then if you feel it's a genuine case, that freedom is left to you. Center name will be printed in the admit card. So there is no confusion. If he comes and claims he is here, he can say it is not here. You can go there. And because we use one and the same database to print admit card and roll number and attendance list, it is hardly possible that he is missing in one and possible in other. If he is missing in all. All the requests that has come here in time, we have done. That has been exceeded because, last time we had 150 students in Bangalore. This time we have 4,000 students in Bangalore. Most of them came to Bangalore after change of venue request. They opted for Kota in the beginning and then wanted to change it to Bangalore. So that thing we have done. Now, accommodating all that, right now we are in a point where we cannot do anything more. So whatever is done, is possible, has been done, and that is reflected in the roll number and in the admit card. No more changes will be accommodated. It is. One possibility is that people who have done online payment, probably as we are now familiar with online payment, sometimes break halfway through and then if the fact is not registered in the system, it might be possible. So in such remote cases, confusion might come. But if there is such case existing, then you would naturally contact IRA in this period before the start of the test. So then we'll know such cases exist or not. As far as we are concerned, we have taken into account all people who have paid through bank. In fact, 212 paid students have paid extra. Two times they paid and three times somebody paid. And then all that money we have paid back. We have reverted through the Axis Bank. So those things are not a problem anymore. See, after all, we only can put in our 101% effort and think about all scenarios and try to avoid that. But still something pops up beyond our comprehension, because beyond our imagination, something extra comes in. We'll definitely be able to help the students. For that, we need your cooperation from your side. Let's together sort it out. Let us know at the earliest if you have any problem. Call us, and then we'll be around. We'll get back to you. We'll keep in touch. So with this few words before concluding the session, personal request is, because all the forms this time has been made into booklets, it is important that they use the booklet already sent to the school. One booklet that is given in the form in the bag is only for your information, because these are all, they do contain less number of forms. Like if for form 4 is required many numbers, in your booklet there will be one form. The booklet that has gone to school will have sufficient number of forms. So they will have to use the same booklet, the booklet that has gone to schools. And Delhi, Calcutta, please. Delhi, Calcutta. Please remember, these two centers, we do have PG on second day. So as I said, MSE test 601 to 617, except 616, we'll have to work on morning 9:30 to 11:30, correct? So in the booklet, there is a printing mistake. So that has to be impressed upon. And actually, we have already sent personal letters to the teachers pointing out these issues. They would already know. But then you also make sure. Students will be given some wiping mechanism, and those facilities are given. The ink pads will be provided. Please note, ink pads will be provided. So they can, if one or two classes they do miss it, they can share it with the other class, because it's only 20 students who are putting it up. So this is true for this class, for the outside Kerala students. So that's something I think I've not mentioned in the communications before. Please keep in mind, it is important to have attendance signature signed by the students and affix their thumb impression in the attendance list. Attendance list is the list with 5 photos in every page, that means 4 sheets for every classroom. It's 20 students per classroom. So that will have their photo, their signature, their name and address, photo approval status, yes or no. Then a space for question booklet code series code, ABCD. Then a space for signature and a space for thumb impression. With this few words, friends, I wish you all the very best for a successful 2012 CAT. Thank you very much.